Patriots, welcome to Rex Finds TV. I'm yours, Donny Lorenzo. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now for our school mission statement.
We the Patriots achieve greatness through high expectations, passion, and perseverance.
Thank you. You may not be seated. Today is Tuesday, February 16th, 2021. Let's go to Aiden for our Black History Spotlight.
Thank you, Yosudani. Today's Spotlight, Brown versus the Board of Education. This case made it illegal for state or local governments or public facilities to deny access to anyone because of ethnic origin or race. It also made segregation in schools illegal and subject to lawsuits. This was monumental in Black equality in our nation. Now let's go to Chris for the sports highlight.
Thank you, Aiden. Today's sports highlights are presented to you by the Patriots. Veteran skydiver Luke Akins makes history by jumping 25,000 feet without a parachute. With more than 16,000 jumps to his credit, professional skydiver Luke Akins has performed many heart-stopping stunts, but his latest feat tops them all. On July 30th, 2016, the 42-year-old daredevil became the first man in the world to leap off a plane from an altitude of 25,000 feet without a wingsuit or a parachute. Instead, he relied on a net that measured 100 by 100 feet, or less than one-third the size of a football field, to break his fall and help him land safely. He then continued the perilous journey by using air currents to direct his body and a GPS helmet to guide him towards the awaiting net. Flying at speeds of up to 120 miles per hour, Akins flipped onto his back before gracefully landing into the net. Now let's go to Noah to see what's for lunch.
Thank you, Chris. Today's lunch is beef and cheese and banana, mixed veggies, mixed fruit and milk. Bon appetit. Now let's get to Sonia for our National Week segment.
Thank you, Noah. Good morning, Patriots. This week is National Random Acts of Kindness Week. This week shows the importance of being kind to others, even if you don't have to. You can do this by leaving positive sticky notes around, letting someone go in front of you in line, or even just saying something nice to a classmate or stranger. These can really brighten people's day, and maybe they just might want to share some kindness too. Happy National Random Acts of Kindness Week. Let's get back to yours, Donnie.
Thank you, Sonia. Scholars, the iReady Challenge is going on now. Keep up the awesome job with the February iReady Challenge. Just a week and a half to go. Pass 20 reading iReady lessons between February 1st and February 26th to join your classmates for an awesome sub-party. You still have time to get your 30 lessons in. Patriots, a few early reminders for important events and activities coming up this week. And next. School picture days are Thursday and Friday, February 18th and 19th. Be sure to wear the appropriate shirt for your grade. There will be no makeup pictures. Also, Thursday is an early release, so remind your parents that you will be getting out of school at 1 p.m. this Thursday. Next week on Monday, February 22nd, our Scholastic Book Fair begins. It will run until March 7th. Keep an eye for additional announcements as we get closer. Patriots, we continue celebrating Black History. Today we recreate and record Black Fraternity Dance or Sorority School. Teachers, you can share a video with us at RPTV by emailing to pines.renaissance@gmail.com or uploading to the RPTV OneDrive. Tomorrow it's time to show off your singing talent. Record yourself singing to your favorite R&B song. Be sure to tune in every day to find out what fun activity or dress down will be going on during the rest of February. Now, let's see what the weather is going to be like today with David.
Thank you, Yosudani. Today's weather in Pembroke Pines, Florida is forecast to be 84 degrees Fahrenheit and scattered thunderstorms. Looks like a good day to play a board game. Now let's go to Samuel for the joke of the day.
Thanks, Samuel. That was great. Today's birthday girls are Sophia Gomez, Soraya Omier, Michelle Mowat, and Chloe Hernandez. Happy birthday! Now let's go back to Yosudani.
Thank you, Solomon. Patriots, don't forget your past expectations. Represent, present yourself positively, act kindly towards others, treat the school as the environment respectfully, and succeed at everything. Congrats to Miss Fletcher, Miss Mraz, Miss Brown, Miss Olvera, Miss Tucker, Miss Antistema, Miss Cherizel, Miss Kane, Miss Hendrickson, Miss Julian, Miss Stone, Miss Jimenez, Miss Calabrese, Miss Manning, Miss Samuel, Miss Antori, Miss Newton, Miss Miguel, Miss Gilbert, Miss Amdenqua, and Miss Velez. You had the correct answer to yesterday's riddle, which was to arrange the following letters to spell just one word, O-O-U-S-W-T-D-N-E-J-R. What is it? The correct answer to the riddle was just one word. Now, for today's riddle. A bus driver was heading down a street in Colorado. He went right past a stop sign without stopping. He turned left where there was a no left turn sign, and he went the wrong way on a one-way street. Then he went on the left side of the road past a cop car. Still, he didn't break any traffic laws. Why not? Again, a bus driver was heading down a street in Colorado. He went right past a stop sign without stopping. He turned left when there was a no left turn sign and went the wrong way on a one-way street. Then he went left on the left side of the road past a cop car. Still, he didn't break any traffic laws. Why not? Teachers, please send your answers to pines.renaissance@gmail.com before 10 a.m. in order for a response to be reviewed. Everyone at RPTV would like to wish you all a terrific Tuesday. Don't forget, remember, unite, rise. Have a great day. Thank you.